I think you read the story where a visitor, a tourist, was thrown from a horse and suffered, I'm told, a muscle injury. So this was on Saturday, and it says the horse just got crazy, sending guests on the busy beach scampering for cover while leaving a trail of destruction. It says the incident could have been worse. There were children playing on the beach. And for years, stakeholders in Negril, which shares both the parishes of Hanover and Westmoreland, have been complaining about out-of-control use, offering horseback riding on the beach illegally. The police have tried to control the issue, but with little success. Apparently, this says not only aging laws, but they don't know what to do with the horses when they capture the horses. The police office, or the police, they don't know.
That's yeah. not funny.
They say they're not in a position to keep the horses.
No, they're not.
2014, he says, while arrests had been made, they don't know what to do with the horses.
If you've seen the state of some of the police officers, they definitely don't have enough space for the horses. Yeah. That's not funny. But what do you do with them?
I don't know. But where they come from, though?
That's
and if
true.
It's illegal, because, well, I mean, could have been much worse, as I just read.
Yeah.
Kids on the beach, anything could happen. Out of control horse. Horse not light, you know. Horse is a very heavy animal, not easy to control.
You know, the question here, Neville, that comes to mind is the fact that it's illegal. Like, what is a legal framework for people who have horses who want to offer the service? Yeah. That's something to
I read when it says one of the problems is due to aging laws.
Mm-hmm.
It says the laws are very antiquated and we need to start informing our guests of where there are beaches that horseback riding can take place,
mm-hmm.
and where it is illegal to ride horses.
Boy, I tell you, you know, it's interesting when the minister comes in. I'm not sure if I'll be conducting that interview, but I think it's you. But I would like to actually know and remind our vendors that they have freedom in the water, that they can walk the water and sell. I was at a beach the other day and I saw the security running off the Jamaican vendors off the sand. And I just looked at the vendors and said, from my recollection, all you need to do is walk in any water and sell. They cannot kick you out of the Jamaican waters, okay? But that's another interesting angle to look at when we're talking about tourism. Never, you said it just before.
Yeah, the Met Service is reporting that we will continue to get more rains through to tomorrow, it says. It says a trough across the Central Caribbean is to move closer to the island and linger for the rest of the week. Linger. Remember what I said, no linger. Well, this is linger.
I want you to do the rain linger dance later. Me and you, we're going to
bust
it. Rain linger.
It says this will result in unstable weather conditions over Jamaica over the next 3 days. The forecast is for cloudy conditions with periods of showers and thunderstorms, which may be heavy at times over most parishes during the afternoon.
Mm. Do you like when it rains?
I love rain. I don't like when it gets too crazy and it's going to flood out people and stuff like that, but I love it.
Do you eat more when it rains?
Yeah, I think so.
Because
I remember that little boy, I used to walk in the rain. I used to love going out in the rain.
You know, I like the idea. My son loves to run in the rain. Nothing wrong with telling him to go run out, go run in the rain.
Yeah.
Just come dry off after.
And then people have this thing that if you go in the rain,
you're going to get cold.
Sick.
But when you have a shower, you're going to get sick.
No, go, sir.
If
you have a little thing going on and then you're wet and then you don't dry
and
yourself
you stay
properly,
wet.
Then fine. But
mm-hmm.
it would suggest that every time you shower, you're going to get sick. Rain don't know nothing at all.
So let's run in the rain. Let's be free. Come on, let's go outside. Go run in the rain.
You don't mind that at all. Let's run, go straight back to my house.
No, we're going to be here till 8:30.
This one is interesting, isn't it?
Yes, His Excellency, the President of the Republic of Zimbabwe, Commander-in-Chief of the Defense Force, one of the oldest and longest-serving leaders, President Mugabe. His Excellency Robert Mugabe, 93 years old, and his family have been detained after Zimbabwe's military staged a bloodless transition. So it's not a military coup, or is it? There has been a takeover. We did see a video of the Major General Mojo, Zimbabwe's military spokesman, come on to the national news, you know, and say to the people that he is safe. His Excellency is actually safe. And we have no idea. It's 2 days now, I think, this has happened. And we haven't seen the president and his family. But since that happened, there was a return of the former Vice President Emmerson Mnangagwa, who's 75, a veteran of Zimbabwe's 1970s liberation wars. He was sacked by Mugabe earlier in the month. Then he returned out of exile right after this takeover.
Which would suggest that it might be a coup.
It might be a takeover. It might be a coup. Boy.
Interesting.
It is very interesting. But Mugabe, boy,
I
tell you.
It seems like the folks are saying that it looked like he was leading to give his wife.
Yes. He was trying to prepare Grace,
right,
who's only 52, by the way.
And then some people are saying that she has some unsavory people
around her,
and they didn't want that. So this is the reason that, but it seems like, to use a word, some skullduggery is going on.
What?
So this is interesting.
Zimbabwe's history has been crazy. I mean, this is some serious history.
Yeah, this is interesting.
Let's see what happens.
We'll come out of this.
We'll see if he's safe. But they're also warning the Americans and the Britons in Zimbabwe. For those watching right now from Zimbabwe on the onespotmedia.com, there has been an advisory. The armored vehicles are patrolling the streets, and they're saying that you should stay indoors. That's the message to you there.
Yep. All right. On Saturday, we were in Montego Bay for the Hospitality Jamaica Awards. So congrats to all those who were awarded.
Yes.
Congrats to Mr. Butch Stewart, who got the first Pioneer Award. Okay. But I met a gentleman, Shandell Buchanan. Well, Shandell Buchanan McNeish is his wife. And husband, I met Maurice McNeish. They're from Cornwall Courts in Montego Bay. It was great to meet you, sir. And I think you're watching, because I told you I'd say hi this morning. So good morning to Mrs. Buchanan McNeish, Shandell. Husband, same love you have proper, and I know you guys watch us, so we thank you for that. And I have a picture here, the great Everett. It is a belated birthday greeting to Shelly-Ann Lawrence. Shelly-Ann is from Craigtown, not certain how you pronounce it. But Shelly-Ann, I got this morning, so I know your birthday has gone. And your good friend didn't give me her name, so I don't know who to say it's from. But to say it's from your very good friend. She says you're a wonderful soul and you watch us all the time. So I thank you for that. And again, I hope you had an absolutely brilliant day on your birthday. And I hope you will continue to watch us. And I have one more now. And this one is Peter John Watson. Here's Peter John. Peter John, I hope you have a great day today. Here you go. Nice outfit. It's coming from your parents. They love you like crazy. And I'm certain your friends and all of us here want to say happy birthday, Peter John. So have a great day. Who you have there, sister?
Peter John, sweetie.
Yeah.
All suited up. You know me. I just want to say happy birthday to anybody that was born today that's watching. Happy birthday to our children, especially those in children's homes, those in foster care. Any young person that's waking up this morning just feeling like they're worth nothing and nobody loves you. Know that we love you. You are somebody. And your life can be greater than what you see in front of you right now. So dream big and just get up and go and give thanks. Give thanks for life. Go.
I have one more.
I know you do.
Yeah, I should have said this, but it was for yesterday. I wasn't here yesterday. Mm-hmm. I wasn't here Monday either. So it says to our daughter, Gabrielle Kelly, who celebrated her 16th birthday, which was yesterday. It says, may God continue to bless you always. We love you dearly from your loving parents. So there you go. So Gabrielle, sorry I didn't do it yesterday because I wasn't here. But I hope you had a great day. And 16 is a beautiful age. You can't stop right
16
here.
16 is beautiful. Yeah. 16 is rough.
16 is beautiful.
Don't 16 is rough.
Her 16 was rough. Yours
My 16
going to be beautiful.
Was rough. Your 16 wasn't rough.
No, but yours is going to be beautiful.
Okay. Well, yeah. Have a great day. It's great being 16.
We'll make the dream become a reality. I know we will. Because our hearts tell us something.